It's safe to say that Nvidia really hasn't had the best of launches in recent memory. With the 4070, 4060 Ti, and now the 4060 being launched, anyone could tell you that Nvidia isn't really giving us what we deserve. But is the recent poor perception of the 4060, more specifically, valid? Is it really all that bad? Or is the 4060 just a misjudged hidden gem amongst all the mid-range cards of today? Starting right off with the specs of this card, Nvidia's decision to put 12GB of VRAM back on the 3060 in 2021 was already met with confusion, but now the drop down to 8GB of VRAM on the 4060 is even worse. This is where we're going to see the 3060 and 6750 XT have a massive advantage, as we'll see later, both offering 12GB of VRAM. Not only that, but its significantly reduced core and TMU counts means no wonder it was met with criticism. And the last straw that broke the camel's back is a drop down to a 128-bit bus, placing this card in an awkward position that really felt like Nvidia was trying to cut costs to increase profits. Not forgetting that this card cost a whole $40 more. But what are some of the redeeming qualities, I hear you ask? Well, since the 4060 gets the treatment of the Ada architecture and 4nm process mode, it's inherently more efficient, enabling higher clocks. As a result, the 4060 sees over a 680MHz increase in boost clocks. But let's now see if these trade-offs really matter in the grand scheme of things. And maybe, just maybe, it's an underappreciated budget card. We're gonna start things off with rasterization at 1080p. But before that, I just want to highlight a few changes that we've made to the testing methodology we use to test cards. The first and obvious one is that we've moved to a new testing platform. We'll be using the AMD Ryzen 7 7800X3D for all future testing, along with fast G-School 6000 Mega Transfers RAM. And courtesy of Asus, we'll be using the ROG Strix X678F Gaming Wi-Fi motherboard for all future testing as well. Some less obvious stuff now, and I'll start by saying that we were aware of some data issues in our previous testing, specifically in GTA 5 and Red Dead Redemption 2. Looking back, the 1.1% lows measured appeared all over the place, and this is due to the fact that we're using the benchmark modes to test the games, which go over various scenes that we were very aware of in those videos. Instead of recording the entire benchmark session like before, we'll only be measuring the final scene of each benchmark to ensure the measurements are recorded consistently. Additionally, for each game we test, we will verify the game settings before performing the benchmark. This is to ensure consistency between each test. A few other notable changes are that we've completely disabled Windows security by going to the group policy editor, and we've also switched to using a local account for the test bench. Why is this important, I hear you ask? Well, by doing it this way, it can minimize the background processes, which can give us more refined data. With that out of the way, let's get to the benchmarks. In rasterization at 1080p, the 4060 does end up showing some decent gains against the 3060, even in CPU-limited CSGO, but consistently falls short of the 3060 Ti, with a significantly higher core count playing a part in that. In one case, in GTA 5, even the 3060 outperforms the 4060, although only by a single frame. But it's disappointing to see this kind of back and forth behavior between the 3060 and 4060, when the 4060 should be the clear winner. That 6750 XT is holding up incredibly well though, even topping the charts in some cases. Interestingly, in Rainbow Six Siege, the 4060 leaps forward, with the gap versus other games increasing significantly. More interestingly, both the 1.1% lows were the smoothest of all the other cards in this instance. Overall, it's a disappointing difference between the 3060 and 4060. And looking at the average FPS for 1080p reveals a really small increase of only 11%. Yes, you heard me right, 11% versus the 3060. That's extremely discouraging if you ask me. The 3060 Ti manages to edge out the 4060 by 6%. And don't get me wrong, it's a small increase, but don't forget that the 3060 Ti is the last gen card. The 4060 does manage to take a hold against the RX 7600 though, by 3%, showing that no one is really winning here, as both AMD and Nvidia really aren't giving us many options. But looking at power consumption is where the questions start to get asked. Are there any redeeming qualities at all in this card? A closer look reveals that this is the case. As compared to the 3060, the 4060 draws 36% less power overall. And despite the 3060 Ti and 6750 XT outpacing the 4060 significantly, it's important to remember that both of those cards draw around 66 to 84% more power. It's interesting looking at the value, because the RX 7600 takes the cake as the best value card at 1080p, despite its lackluster performance due to its pricing. But since Nvidia cut the price of the 3060, that's now the best value Nvidia card, which once again places the 4060 in an awkward position, being in no man's land in terms of value. But if what you're after is performance for what, which is currently crucially important with rising power prices, then the 4060 is clearly the best bet. On average, the 4060 has the best performance per watt by far, even superseding the 7600 by 25%, and offering a whopping 1.7 increase in efficiency versus that 3060. Although not targeted at 1440p, we couldn't hold back from running the 4060 through its paces of 1440p. And at 1440p, the gap between the 4060 and 3060 does widen significantly, especially in more intensive titles like F1 and Forza. This is most likely because we are becoming more GPU bound as we move up to 1440p. But it's still worth pointing this out. The 3060 Ti's lead over the 4060 is further exemplified, and the 6750 XT is showing a strong lead over the pack, delivering a much smoother experience over the other cards. That RX 7600, on the other hand, is still struggling to take any sort of lead over the 4060, even losing to the A750 in Hitman 3 and Spider-Man Remastered. Ultimately, this brings us to the 1440p rasterization summary, where the notion of the gap widening with the 3060 and 4060 is confirmed, with the 4060 gaining a 16% increase over the 3060. While still not an amazing increase in performance, testing of 1440p has helped to highlight a more significant underlying increase that the 4060 had, as we were becoming more GPU bound from going to 1080p to 1440p. However though, it still confirms an even wider gap between the 4060 and 3060 Ti, with the 3060 Ti disappointingly still taking a 9% lead over the 4060, and the RX 6750 XT is taking a similar lead. Although the RX 7600 does take a lead over the previous gen RTX 3060 and its predecessor, the 6650 XT, the 4060 still wins it by 9%, once again further exemplified by the jump to 1440p. Moving along to power consumption, once again Ada's power efficiency is on full display, drawing 35% less power than its predecessor, the 3060, and consuming 45% less power than the 3060 Ti, and similarly with the RX 6750 XT. It's also hard to even see a real difference between the 6650 XT and 7600, as not only do they perform along the same lines, but their power consumption is almost identical. Looking at the performance per dollar for 1440p, shows the 7600 once again being the best value, with the A750 coming in as the second best, which wasn't the case at 1080p, but once again is exemplified as we become more GPU bound. But the 4060 is no longer in no man's land, being identical in value as compared to its predecessor, reinforcing the need for retesting of 1440p, as it highlights the underlying performance difference you don't really see at lower resolutions. Finally, is the performance per watt, and again Ada's raw strength and power efficiency is further exemplified, with it now being 1.8 times more efficient than its predecessor, and furthermore being 30% more efficient than the RX 7600. So what we've seen so far is that when it comes to rasterization, the difference between the 4060 and 3060 is extremely small, but more prominently at 1440p due to the fact that the 4060 is becoming more GPU bound. We saw the 4060's value teeter more in line with the 3060 as well. Additionally, its stellar performance per watt and efficiency could make this card a potential option for buyers due to the rise in power prices. If the 4060 can match the value of the 3060 while drawing considerably less power, it means that this card would have been surprisingly underappreciated. We'll have to wait and see as we get into the ray tracing tests and benchmarks. We didn't even touch on things like DLSS 3 frame generation, as we'll be touching on that in a separate video coming later, comparing each AI upscaler. Now for ray tracing at 1080p, well, the story is much the same as rasterization in terms of the difference between the 3060 and 4060. Out of the cards we tested, the 3060 Ti is undoubtedly the best, topping the charts almost all the time. In games like Spider-Man Remastered, surprisingly the 3060 ends up taking the lead over the 4060, with a considerably smoother 1.1% loads, which is quite disappointing to say the least. Being a surprise to no one, the 4060 still undoubtedly takes the cake over the RX 7600, often reinforcing that Nvidia is just better for ray tracing, and nobody can argue against that. Now taking a closer look at the 5 game average FPS for 1080p for ray tracing, reveals that small difference you've been waiting for, with the 4060 only pulling ahead of its predecessor by 14%. As usual, the 3060 Ti leads the 4060, this time by 10%, and surprisingly, the 6750 XT gets a leg up when it comes to ray tracing performance, unlike the two lower end cards from AMD. Beating the 4060 merely by 3%. Moving on to power consumption. As usual, the 4060 draws the least power as compared to the 3060. The 4060 drew 34% less power, showing that even when ray tracing, the 4060 is still impressively efficient. Furthermore, the 4060 draws 44% less power than the 3060 Ti, and similarly with the 6750 XT. As for the performance per dollar, surprisingly, the A750 tops the chart as the best value card for ray tracing at 1080p, with the rest of the top three being the 3060 and 4060, which have similar value all things considered, demonstrating once again how the 4060 has the potential to be a decent option given its greatly reduced power draw. And once again, looking at the performance per watt, the 4060 is leading the charts again, being 1.7 times more efficient than the 3060. All the while, the 4060 slams the RX 7600, being 59% more efficient than it. Moving on to 1440p, it's again much of the same, although surprisingly in Cyberpunk, the 4060 ends up leading the chart, but not by a considerable margin. And if you're wondering, yes, the gap did widen between the 3060 and 4060, but the difference is obviously still not significant. In Hitman 3 though, we see the 3060 take a considerable lead over the 4060, due to the 3060 having that extra 4GB of VRAM, which seems to check out as the 3060 Ti also falls behind as well. However, the A750, even though it has 8GB of VRAM, isn't hampered for some reason, which could come down to optimization. But regardless, if it took us all this way to get the ray tracing of 1440p to the point where we are being limited by VRAM, why do people complain that the 4060 only has 8GB of VRAM? The RX 7600 also begins to fall considerably behind, which is the final nail in the coffin for its pretty terrible ray tracing performance. Finally, getting to the final summary for gaming. Interestingly, despite AMD's known track record of being garbage at ray tracing, the 6750 XT shows a surprising lead, pulling ahead of the 4060 by 11%. At the same time, the 4060's gap between the 3060 narrows, with the 4060 beating it by 10% in average frames, despite in some instances considerably outpacing it in those 5 games. The 3060 Ti yet again still has the advantage over the 4060 being 8% faster on average. The usual stuff applies when we look at the average power draw, with the 4060 drawing 37% less power than its predecessor, additionally consuming 50% less power than the 6750 XT and 42% less power than the 3060 Ti. And touching on performance per dollar, once again the A750 leads the pack, with the 3060 and 4060 coming in with similar value, nothing new here. And lastly, touching on the performance per watt, we once again see that increase in efficiency that we've come to expect from, with a 1.7 times more performance per watt versus the 3060. The increase compared to the other cards stays consistent, with once again the 4060 taking the lead in efficiency over the RX 7600 by 64%. In both 1080p and 1440p ray tracing scenarios, the 4060 consistently showcases its efficiency by drawing less power than its competitors, while still delivering decent performance. However, the 3060 and 6750 XT sometimes outpace the 4060 in raw performance. The 4060's performance per watt remains unmatched. The 3060 does occasionally give the 4060 a run for its money, especially at 1440p, where VRAM becomes a significant factor. The RX 7600, however, struggles with ray tracing, affirming NVIDIA's dominance in this domain. The A750, however, unexpectedly offers the best value in ray tracing, but if efficiency isn't the main criteria, the 4060 emerges as a front runner. The minimal VRAM of the 4060 as well, often criticized, does not seem to be a substantial impediment in real world gaming scenarios. Moving along to the benchmarks, we started with 3DMark Firestrike, which reveals a decent improvement in DirectX 11 performance on the 4060 versus the 3060, with TimeSpy revealing a smaller but adequate improvement in DX12 performance as well. Ray tracing in Port Royal, on the other hand, reveals a minor overall improvement in this area, but the 3060 Ti's superior specs allow it to supersede the 4060. Additionally, even the Arc A750 and RX 7600 take a hold on it. But given that this wasn't really the case at all when we looked at real world gaming performance, these results should obviously be taken with a grain of salt and represent the best case scenario for all of these cards in terms of optimization. In Blender, surprisingly, the 4060 showcases an astonishing lead over its predecessor of 40%, showcasing its raw strength in 3D rendering and even topping all the other cards by a considerable margin. Looking at the Luxmark results reveals another surprising result, not in favor of our 4060, as the RK 750 tops the chart in OpenCO renderer, even leaving the 4060 in the dust by a considerable 34%. The 4060 still topples its predecessor by a respectful 16%, however. Moving along to Passmark performance test. test, it reveals a lackluster increase of 11%, showcasing its overall improvement. As Passmark runs through various APIs, such as DirectX 11 through to 12, as well as OpenCL. Additionally, the 3060 Ti beats the 4060 by 7% and ends up topping the charts, quite like what we saw during gaming. Looking at some more real-world usage, now in the Adobe Suite, using Puget Bench, and starting us off with After Effects reveals an extremely disappointing result from the 4060, losing by 17% in the GPU score versus its predecessor. This one stuck out like a sore thumb to me, and it helps to further highlight the effect of the 4060's severely reduced specs. Most prominently, it's reduced core count and memory bus, which have had a major effect on its ability to render various scenes in After Effects. And it's something that a lot of reviewers don't touch on. Not everyone buys GPUs for just gaming. They also use for various other workloads. Testing in After Effects has helped to highlight a broader basis for the GPU. Its performance even falls slightly behind the RX 7600, so it's disappointing to say the least. Moving on to Premiere Pro, it's much of the same again. It loses by 11% versus its predecessor. And even though Premiere Pro relies more heavily on the GPU's encoders, its rendering capabilities still haven't affected, which shows in a significantly reduced performance. Last up for today is another more real-world productivity-focused benchmark, with SpecViewPerf. We tested using three of the more popular 3D rendering CAD applications, which includes Maya, SolidWorks, and 3ds Max. And the results will surprise you. AMD seemingly takes the cake over all the other cards in Maya, with the 6750 XT running rings around the 4060 and performing a whopping 61% better. But AMD's advantage is not just limited to Maya, as all three of the cards we tested handily outperformed NVIDIA. The 4060 does, however, lead over the 3060 by 16% in Maya and 25% in SolidWorks. But that's as far as the 4060's lead goes, as the 3060 takes the lead in 3ds Max over the 4060 by 7%. Well, to sum up all the benchmarks, the 4060 demonstrates mixed results across our benchmarks. While it showcases notable improvements over its predecessor, the 3060, in areas like 3D Mark, Firestrike, and Blender, it struggles in real-world applications like After Effects and Premiere Pro, perhaps due to its reduced core count and memory bus. Although the 4060 outperforms the 3060 in certain 3D rendering applications such as Maya and SolidWorks, it falls behind other competitors like the AMD 6750 XT and even the 3060 in 3ds Max. Despite its strengths, buyers should carefully consider the GPU's performance in relation to their specific needs and workloads. Now, as for overclocking on the 4060, with the ASUS dual card we have here, we were able to boost the core clock by 200 MHz and the memory clock by 1500 MHz, which ended up resulting in what I would say a disappointing improvement in performance. We only really see around an 8% improvement in average frames in Heaven benchmark, with the 1.1% lows barely increasing either. Thankfully, however, this didn't result in a massive increase in power, as that only increased by 3%, preceding the temperature and noise levels, the temperature of which didn't even change, and the noise levels of this card, which only saw a small increase of 6%. In conclusion, the RTX 4060 faced valid criticism, particularly regarding its reduced VRAM, core count, and memory bus width. While these seem like cost-cutting moves, performance test shows that this isn't that simple. The 4060 slightly surpasses the 3060 in 1080p rasterization, but doesn't consistently beat the 3060 Ti or AMD 6750 XT. Its performance boost is more apparent at 1440p though. The card's main advantage is its efficiency. It consumes less power while delivering commendable performance, especially in ray tracing. Though it excels in benchmarks like 3D Mark, Firestrike, and Blender, it lags in tasks like After Effects and Premiere Pro. Overclocking brings limited gains, thus the 4060's appeal is a balance of performance and power efficiency. Buyers should weigh the pros and cons against their needs before purchasing. So that about wraps up our review of the 4060. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. And on that note, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Make sure to check out the review we did on the RK 750 as well.